Say YouTube. This is part four and final for the build of the Harbor Freight trailer. I live in the great state of Pennsylvania. Before you buy one, you need to decide, is it worth it? There's a little cost involved that, of course, I did not know, and probably when I move out, different state, whatever, even in staying in the state, I'll do a little more research before doing something like this again. So there's the cost of the trailer and the shipping. I do love the trailer. I went to DMV. They told me exactly what I had to have done prior to going back to register the trailer. One was bring it to a quarry, have it weighed, get the slip from them, make sure your name is on it. Trailer with the build that I did with the 3-inch PVC conduit was 200 pounds. After that, you have to bring it to a garage that does trailer inspections. They inspect it, go over it. I told them, being in the instructions, it did not state what to torque the bolts down. So all of the frame bolts I did to 350-inch pounds, the axle bolts I did, which are the U-bolts, to 220-inch pounds. I think the lugs were like 80 pounds. So after having it inspected, which cost me $115, then I got their paperwork. Then I was able to go to DMV. Now, DMV, with their cost, because you only have a slip of paper from Harbor Freight that you purchased it. Yes, it's got the serial number and all of that stuff on it, but it's not a title. So I had to pay $125 in order to get this thing registered. $6, of course, is the yearly fee, and the other amount of money and all the paperwork has to get shipped to Harrisburg. So the total cost was $125 to get a title for the trailer. So, needless to say, I'm not going to be selling this trailer anytime soon of all the work that I had to go to get this thing on the road. But it is a beautiful trailer. Just to go over some other little add-ons I did. I put two hold downs on each side. I moved down this bracket that, you know, has the bumper stop. I lowered it down two notches. I didn't know where it was going to lie once I got the Kayak. So you can see I had to move it all the way down, only because I like the way it fits down into the V a little bit better. Again, it is a beautiful trailer. If you should decide to do one of these builds, I would definitely contact Motor Vehicle and find out what's involved to get one of these. Oh yeah, another thing that it says on the bill of sale, whatever you want to call it, that Harbor Freight gives you, is that it is a kit. And being it stamped with that being a kit, that's why I had to go through this whole rigmarole to get this thing on the trailer. Again, I had the upgrade from 8 to 12. I had my friend watch me from behind as I trailered it beautifully. I do have to check the tire pressure on it. It might be a little bit too high, so I may have to lower the pressure a little bit. These 45s, I think they were like $8 a piece. I got it at a home center. Well worth it, because once it hits it, it just rides right up on top of it and onto the trailer. It's your call if you want to do it. I love it. Yeah, you know, it's something you have to test yourself. But, again, well worth it. I won't take them off. Again, I did not glue them on. As you can see, I did sand a little bit around the pipes so they do go on and off easier. But again, well worth it. Because when the Kayak hits it, it just rides right up and onto the trailer. So I went fishing yesterday. Caught 22 fluke,
one bluefish, and I think it was a croaker. It looks like either a croaker or a drum, black drum. Caught a lot of mullet in my casting net. This was a little mullet holder, bait holder I made that drags behind. But I'm just getting everything all cleaned up now. Again, trailer was, I'm not going to say worth the cost, but I do like the trailer. So I'm just going to leave it at that. You make that decision, contact, you know, motor vehicle, find out what's involved in doing one of these builds prior to purchasing it. All right, YouTube, hope this is helpful. Any questions, give a shout out. Y'all have a good day.